Good morning, everyone. How are you doing on this beautiful sunny Tuesday morning? Zach was over there talking to TQ. She wore a hoodie out. He's like, you know, it's supposed to be 84 degrees here today, right? And it's already scorcher, man. It's like 8:30, 9 o'clock in the morning here. Look at that. It's gonna be a good day. Good day. Anyways, TQ had to rip her hoodie off real quick because it's already baking. Look at this bad boy. Oh. But that's all going to change. It's going to be a short-lived 4 days of nice weather.
All right, guys, I'm finally here.
Nice of you to join us, TQ.
Thanks. I had to take my hoodie off. I'm sure he already told you.
I did. How was your weekend, Zach?
It was good.
Yeah? Did you go viral on any TikToks?
We did okay. We did about average.
About average? What's your average for a view?
Probably 10,000 to 30,000.
Oh, that's good. That's real good. Consistently? Oh, yeah. I like consistent views, you know, if they stay consistent. So,
right.
You don't like it when it goes blue.
Yeah.
Post a video and it's got 100 views like 6 hours later. You're like, what the heck?
Thought that one was happened plenty of times.
It does happen all the time. I'm like, that video is going viral, no doubt. 80 views. Like, what the heck, TikTok? You broke today? Anyways, we're going to get rocking and rolling here. We're going to take care of everything this week and everything next week that needs taken care of, because the Equip Expo is coming. I think you only got like a day or two left with the pre-sale tickets or whatever. Code Spencer will save you 50%. Get to it. So they went ahead and mowed the big field out front. Well, I shouldn't say mowed. They brush cut this bad boy. Anyways, they actually came up the power lines as well, the telephone pole area on this side. And I'm going to show you, because back there where we're typically fighting it, that's an area we have to maintain so they can normally ride a four-wheeler or whatever they do to go back through there. Well, they cut this baby way back. So that's good for us, but they made a bit of a mess. We'll have to deal with it. So I'll show you up front here. We typically mow back to about here. So we got a little bit here on the edge. We're gonna take care of that. They took care of this big old field. And then right here, you see that power pole? That strip goes all the way up. I'll show you in just 1 second. We'll be right back. pay attention when TQ comes back this way with the mulching blades on. With the high lift, typically we're getting 3 rows to 4 rows of dispersion out the deck, okay? With the mulching blades, you typically get 2 at most, most of the time 1.5. Gives you a general idea of the difference between the blades. The high lifts are meant to get it up and get it out as fast as possible and as far as possible to really disperse it. The mulching blades are meant to just mulch it up into tiny bits and to get it back into the lawn, which puts a ton of nutrients into the lawn. Should be able to see it better this way. So see, we're maybe getting 2 length there in person. Yeah, you can kind of pick it up there a bit. So check that out. They came all the way up through those telephone poles. I'd say probably a solid 20 feet off each end. And then I never even knew there was a hill here. They went straight on through to the back. So our path for them to bring the four-wheeler through to go check what they needed to was over here. And we were told just to keep that clear. So now, as you can see, that is not a problem whatsoever. Taking a peek in here because we might, there's some rock and stuff. Check this hill out. Had no clue that hill was even there. There's a drain that comes out, a couple drains. That must be from the downspouts. Had no idea. Yeah, this where it normally comes around. Pretty cool. Might try to keep the majority of this knocked down to maybe, I don't know, just deck heights. I definitely can't go low. There's pipes and rock and who knows what else underneath all this dead stuff. But yeah, pretty crazy. They should have just went ahead and knocked that little strip down.
the driveway, and Sean is back here finishing up mowing. And they'll be ready to go. Good job, fellows.
Thank you.
Fellers.
Let's move on.
Got a woolly bear. Let's check them out. What do you guys think? They say they predict the winner. He's cruising.
All right, guys, so we are at this property here. The boys are gonna get the mowing done and I'm gonna do some trimming. Nope.
Yep. Nope.
It is heating up. It would have been funny if Ramir would have drove by and just kicked it.
Thank you.
All right, guys, TQ's right here. Zach's finishing up that side. I had to double cut the back here. It was just pretty tall and pretty wet with all the shade. But we got it whipped back into shape.
He just did the first leaf cleanup. All right, just finished this one up. It stripes up very pretty. This side really doesn't do it justice just because of the sun placement.
Back, roll it up like hay.
Oh no, cone flip? Good job.
There you go.
All right, let's move it on.
In case you don't know, he didn't land it.
It wasn't on camera, it didn't happen.
And also, we're doing the one across the street there. We make sure we take everything with us, the trimmers, the blowers, that way we don't have to keep coming back and forth. Those right there for now.
Literally.
So he ran out of string just as we got here. Good thing I had some in my back pocket.
Yeah.
Are these the trimmer heads that you run?
These are the Echo Species, right?
Yeah. string's a little short. There you go. Simple, simple.
You ran out of string, didn't you?
Yeah, how you know about that?
I saw you trucking it back across the yard.
Literally, right when I got started, I'm like, of course.
What did I tell you in the truck, too?
Get some string.
I literally said, hey. I told you to walk in shame, man. It happens every time on this lawn. So we got to park down there. Just, it's easiest place to park. This road's super busy. I said, hey, make sure we got string, guys. Well. Zach will learn. Look at the leaves. Leaves everywhere. So Zach couldn't believe earlier how fast we were with three of us getting properties done. Because see, Zach has a lawn care business in his neighborhood where he goes all around and takes care of his own properties. And he's like, man, with three of us, we're just flying through these properties. A lot of them we just kind of went on through and, you know, don't record some. Some are just dried up, so we're just moving really rapidly. But he's like, I can't believe how much faster it is with a few people. I said, yeah, two's quick, three, you're blazing. Thank you. So mulching and leaves, okay? If you have a ton of leaves, you are not going to want to mulch all of that into the lawn. If you can still see a ton of leaves like caked onto the top, you got to get that off there. What it's going to do is smother your lawn, and it's going to kill the lawn. You're not going to like that. Now, something like this where it's not overly bearing just yet, we're just going to continue mulching these in as the season progresses.
Just responding on Instagram while you guys are up there filming.
We were working.
Yeah, they're good. They're good job.
I like the angle cut on that. It's been a minute since you did that.
Yeah.